Every hour, I need you. Every moment, I need you. Father God, we thank you that as you have been taking us through the journey of experiencing happiness, experiencing joy in this world, Jesus, you taught your disciples the secret. And on the first day, O Lord, you spoke to us about being poor in spirit. Yesterday you spoke to us of being blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Mourning is those who repent. And today you are taking us still deeper. Verse number 5, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Thank you, Lord. And as you are taking us through this journey, you are showing us that each one of us have the freedom of choice. Our choices decide our attitude. And it is our attitude that decides our altitude. Every moment we have choices, we have freedom. Help us to understand your ways so that from now on, being vigilant, we will no longer be moved by our emotions, by our flesh, that is making us take choices or decisions that will displease you. So here we are in your presence, Lord. Your word says you show us the path of our life. In your presence, there is joy forevermore. And there is pleasure in your right hand. So here we are willing to not only repent, but willing to cooperate with you, agree with you, your word, and let the truth destroy every negative teaching, deception. Let it be exposed in the presence of your truth, that we, now knowing the truth, will not only apply the truth and experience freedom, but we will be your disciples going out and sharing this good news everywhere we go. We thank you, we praise you, Lord, for the great and mighty experience that we are all going to experience in the glorious name of Jesus. And I ask you, Father, a special anointing on me, O Lord, too, so that I speak what you want me to speak to your people. That when we go from this place, we are not going back home the same. Our lives are being changed. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. So from the last 3 days, we have been studying from the Bible steps to experience happiness. And we, on the first day, learned about being poor in spirit, where Jesus began to show us that our happiness never ever depends on circumstances or people or situations. It is the choices that we make. Praise God. Unless I'm poor in spirit, I cannot go to the second step to be blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Only when a person has got that attitude of being poor in spirit, and you learn a very powerful truth that Paul was extremely rich spiritually. In other words, he had extreme revelations from God. But even though he had extreme revelations,